Hey there, Capricorn. I'm Infiniti, and welcome to your April full moon reading for 2021. I'm excited to have you here and get going with this reading. If I'm new to you, welcome. Welcome to my channel. I am a shaman, mystic, medical medium, psychic, physical, empath, natural born energy healer. I work with tarot and oracle, obviously. I also work with people and their animals all over the world for deep energy healing and clearing, as well as ascension coaching. I'm also an artist, and I'll be offering up more services in that regard coming soon. So I encourage you to check out my website, thehealingbutterfly.org. And without further ado, let's get into your reading, Capricorn. Balance spirituality and practicality. So to have a good balance here, this is full moon in Pisces energy. So, balance spirituality and practicality. Okie dokie. Well, what I'm getting here is maybe there's been too much balancing going on being more practical in the kind of material, real world sense, and not so balanced in the spirituality part of it, or being very picky and choosy about how you decide this is spiritual and I'm doing spiritual work, even though it feels like there's something's avoidant I'm hearing. The Lovers, intimate relationships, carefully weigh decisions, and good health. So maybe this is having to do with, and Raphael is who I work with in my healings. And he is the archangel known for healing. And the Lovers coming through here is, it's not about always about lovers, as you probably know. It's about intimate relationships and being close to other people. That is also a part of spirituality. And probably one of the hardest parts to navigate as we ascend, as we change, as we evolve, as we heal from our first life and go into the second life and integrate those, how you were with who you are and moving forward. Let's go to the Archangel Oracle. It's what I'm feeling here. Capricorn, again, welcome. Jeez. Cards are popping and my fingers and hands are not working, so it's a really deadly combination. Oh my goodness. We got Nurture with Archangel Gabriel. As you nurture a child, you nurture your own inner child. Both activities are important for you right now. Interesting. So we got the Lovers speaking about healing, so nurturing, that sort of thing, really being intimate, nurturing an intimate relationship, or being vulnerable in an intimate relationship, or extending yourself in an intimate relationship. And then we got Nurture with Archangel Gabriel speaking to nurturing yourself, self-love, nurturing the inner child, connecting with the inner child. And maybe that's what this is about. Maybe this is about getting in touch with that inner child, getting what will help you get closer to others as well. That balance of practicality and spirituality, and you see those two fish, that's a relationship. That's that is the yin and the yang, and the divine feminine, the divine masculine, the inner, the outer, the you now and the inner child, you being having unconditional love and expressing that and all that kind of stuff. So that's interesting. I'm hearing, let's get another one. Oh, top one. Okay. Really feeling Archangel Gabriel here. Archangel Gabriel, it is time for you to assume your leadership power and position and lovingly guide others. So in order to do this leadership thing that Archangel Gabriel is speaking of, we really need to open up our hearts with unconditional love. Again, the lovers coming through. So we have leadership, nurture, unconditional love coming through with that nurture card, really speaking to our soul, our inner child, and the need to assume our power, assume who we are. It's time for you to assume your leadership power and position and lovingly guide others. And maybe you're already doing this in a different capacity, but this is talking also about whatever you're doing. It's great, but don't get stuck in habitual things without expanding, without opening up your heart to discovering what else is there for you or who else is there for you. I want to get into this tarot. I'm feeling the tarot. Let's get into the wild unknown and see what we get here, Capricorn. So this is really interesting. Because this is about your relationship with you, mostly, and how you relate to others through your own your own awareness of your emotions is kind of what I'm feeling here. Whoa. Goodness gracious. The cards today, I swear, are just flying. Flying. I'm going to keep that one that flipped over, which is the Ace of Swords. Ace of Swords with that infinity symbol right side up. Okay. The Five of Swords in reverse. So two sword cards here. Next card, the Moon. So definitely working with this Moon energy. We've gotten the Moon in every single one of these readings. I think so. Or maybe not with one of them, but with most of them. So Ace of Swords, Five of Swords, the Moon. So we have change coming in. Really, it is with this infinity symbol. This is always speaking to me. You know, I don't only notice it because my name is Infinity, but I noticed this very specifically here with this card, with this Ace of Swords, because if you see that electricity, that energy coming out from the heavens, from above, it's basically activating your Merkaba, sending you light codes, preparing you for the incoming Stargate is what I'm hearing here. You're going to sever some old programming, things that hold you back, have held you back. Definitely this full moon, this is the Moon card. This Moon is coming through very, very, interesting. Mother of Cups and then Daughter of Pentacles. But Mother of Cups is in reverse. And then we have Daughter of Pentacles right after her, after this Moon card. One more card here with Seven of Swords in reverse. Sorry, I'm doing that kind of fast. And then we have our mother of, this is how this looks. So picking up on some unresolved mother energy, motherly, divine feminine. So this could be a mother, grandmother, wife, girlfriend, sister, aunt, cousin, best friend, type of person. And we have five of wands, the lovers, the death card under here. Okay. So definitely speaking to person, relationship. So maybe one, maybe there are several relationships that can, that you're like, well, could be this, 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 this. Maybe it's all of them. But where is a relationship, some soul connection, some something here that is like tied to your ascension, tied to your evolution, tied to your balancing of your spirituality and your practicality, shifting from the material matrix to, see that sticking out there? Soul retrieval. Oh, that is hilarious. And freedom. One more. Beauty. Oh, I love this. This is awesome. Sometimes the cards are just too friggin' funny. I get a lot of that. Love it. This is why we love cards around here. So, soul retrieval. Awesome. We have Middle World with Galena, the crystal Galena, I'm not familiar with. I love this oracle because it's teaching me about crystals that I'm not yet familiar with, even though I have a house full of them. Middle World, soul retrieval, card number 29. So that's an 11. Blue barite with freedom, and the animal spirit is eagle. And then we have beauty with the autumn energy with wow, Eudaylite, Eudaylite. I've never heard of that, but I'm gonna look it up. With beauty. And we have, again, and I'm just directed to this mother of cups and this daughter of pentacles here. As soon as I said beauty, I looked at them. Freedom is coming in under the moon, and soul retrieval is coming in under ace of swords and that five of swords. So we have great change coming here. Coming up here, a lot of evolution, a lot of change here with soul retrieval gravitating here towards that ace of swords and the five of swords. Five and the swords, you know, we're deleting programming, we're cutting cords, severing our tie to the past, moving into the future. And with soul retrieval, we're talking about connecting to the Akashic, connecting to this real shamanic type energy there. Freedom coming in under this moon. So we definitely have, again, this activation energy coming in with this full moon. Very powerful. It is a super full moon. And the energy of the full moon is and has been very potent for at least the last couple days, and it's not even until for another day and a half. So it's been really intense with the full moon, with the full moon energy. I'm being guided to grab the book for this soul retrieval card and read a little bit about this. This is a new deck to me, so I like learning. So, oh my gosh, why? There we go. Okay, Middle World, Galena. Soul retrieval. You have a attracted this card today as there is an opportunity for you to receive a soul retrieval healing. Throughout life, we all at some point experience a trauma that can create a fracture in our energy. Most people can look back on their life and pinpoint an experience that shaped them differently and caused them to relate to life in a different way. When we experience a frightening event or trauma, a piece of us, a positive aspect, is frozen and left in that time and place within the energy body. Healers and shamans work powerfully to heal these fractures using a process called soul retrieval. This is where they travel through timelines to the spirit world to retrieve this energy and bring it back into the physical and into the present moment, where this energy can heal the original fracture at a very deep level. Do you feel like a part of you is missing? Do you have a memory of a trauma that keeps raising its head? Do you feel unsettled and as though you're in need of some healing? Now is the time to connect to the positive energy that you had before the traumatic experience. It's time to heal this old trauma so you can free yourself from the fragmented energy in your life. It's time to reclaim this aspect of yourself and live your life with a deep sense of peace. Make sure to do the ceremony to assist you in this process and find a healer or shaman to work with you. So, that is definitely something that I do. I do it as kind of a, I don't do it as a, this is just a Pete, this is just a soul retrieval thing. I do it as a part of a bigger healing program that I offer called the Evolve Now program. And we definitely work with that if that comes up. But and on different levels it does with people for sure. But when this is coming out, and what I'm feeling here with you is, aside from this being very specifically, like, this is very much speaking to specific soul retrieval, it's about just general healing and clearing and meditation and connecting, nurturing the inner again, going within, really using this full moon energy. And I will be doing a guided astral meditation for the full moon, as I almost always do. So I would suggest that you watch that. That could have components of this within it, I'm kind of seeing. But aside from that, it's a good idea to think about, I'm just hearing connecting with your higher self, with your soul. And to do that on a regular basis would mean to keep your energy clear, be in a place where there's not a lot of negative energy, go out into nature often, expand what it is that you do creatively. All those types of things will connect you better with your soul. And just to have the intention of getting to that, I'm looking at leadership, and it's like, in order to lead, we need to be led, and we need to be led by our souls, and we need to really allow for that to happen. And there is real freedom in that. There is real freedom in that. And this eagle energy is very strong, that's coming through here as well. We have two birds, Raphael, Gabriel, the daughter, and the mother of cups, the daughter of pentacles. Again, I'm being directed here to this kind of divine feminine. It's like it's really time to connect and to heal and to connect and heal with the divine feminine aspects, like in the physical that are in your world, that, you know, who is part of your, again, who is part of your ascension, who is part of your evolution, what needs to be a deeper connection there, because that will help you. Don't hold back. Let go of fear, I'm hearing. I'm going to take out some. Let's get into. No, I'm being redirected to the Dreams of Gaia Oracle instead of the Light Seers. Interesting. So let's see what we get here. A little bit more clarity for you, Capricorn. But definitely this divine feminine energy. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say. So that either the people in your life, or if this hasn't come into your world yet, if this is a person, if you're like, no, there's nobody like this yet, or it's been a long time or something like that. But I think mostly there, I think that, well, it could be either thing. I'm seeing both of these situations. It could be somebody you already know or somebody that you don't know yet, but they're a divine feminine energy. So don't get caught up in actual, you know, genders. It's not about gender. It's about energy. So the real way to like kind of differentiate between a feminine and a masculine. So feminine is nurturing. Feminine energy is very nurturing, and masculine energy is very protective. That's like the simplest, most basic way that I could put that. But without getting too deep into it, let's see what we got here. King of Earth. Are we going in reverse here? No. Okay, so we got King of Earth, and then Three of Fire, and then Seven of Earth. So this is about healing, about grounding, about connecting with Gaia, with your energy, obviously, with your chakras. Really, again, healing. Clearing energy, grounding energy, leaving the busy, I'm hearing. Maybe time to take a couple days off consecutively to kind of go, okay, for these 2-3 days, I'm not going to connect. I'm maybe do a silent detox, or like a what's it called? You go into silence for a period of time, 24, 48, 72 hours, where you don't speak or communicate with anybody. You just stay real quiet and within yourself. I'm picking up on that here. This will help you connect with Gaia, with the moon, with the activations coming through. So whenever, and if you can do that, I would highly suggest that you do that. You could also partition it out. So if you're like, well, I could take a vacation in August, it's gonna be a while before I can't talk at all to anybody or leave my house or anything like that. What you could do is set time periods of the day up where it's like, okay, if you must work, if you must go out or whatever, but this sounds really good to you otherwise, then be like, okay, between this hour and this hour, like I'm only gonna talk for work. Other than that, everybody in my life, please know I'm on a staycation silent retreat within myself, and we can get back to normal in 24, 48, 72 hours. If you have to do a partition type silent practice, then I would suggest you make it longer so you can have more of that time. But if you could have it consecutively, like 24 hours consecutively, 48, 72, I would do that. So that is coming through, this King of Earth coming in right with this Ace of Swords. Uh, I'm hearing crystals, crystals, crystals. You may be guided to acquire new crystals, and I'm feeling like carnelian, ruby, anything red. As I'm seeing this red crystal here, I'm kind of spacing on like red crystals, but, or do a Google search, crystals that are red or maroon in color, because I'm really feeling that. So, and we've got this three of fire here. So I really feel like starting here at the root chakra would be really good. Maybe working on or working with somebody to clear your chakras, or do it yourself. Spend a day listening to music that will help you with clearing out your energy. I'm seeing the 396 frequency is coming into view for me here. So I would look into that. Okay. And I do believe that is it. Lovely Capricorn. I want to thank you for being here. Just remember, we've got to work on your own relationship with your energy, and that balance of spirituality, and that's just coming through the nurturing of the inner child. I have a meditation for that, so if you have not done that yet, it's healing the inner child, integrating with the inner child. I highly, highly recommend that awesome channeled guided meditation for self-healing and connecting with the inner child. I feel that coming through a lot here, but you're gonna definitely feel a lot of push and a lot of activation to act, to move, to express, to communicate, to lead yourself into this new set of timelines, this new chapter is really what I'm seeing here. But this information about this divine feminine energy is pretty strong here. So identify that for yourself. Who are we talking about in the physical? Who are we talking about? Maybe, you know, if anybody's crossed over, maybe that's an energy that's coming through as well for you. And it started off with, I feel this intense mother energy that needs to be rectified, figured out, turned right side, because this mother of cups again is in reverse. The daughter of pentacles right next to it is telling me that it's like partly there, partly figured out for you, or you've been kind of working on it, or you've done some of this work already, or you are aware that there's something that needs to be set right. Yeah. But let's not forget, we're working on a soul-based level with this soul retrieval. We're working on a soul-based level to have that freedom, so you can get to that beauty, so you can have that freedom, because it feels right now that you're just kind of locked and you maybe don't know what direction to go in, or you're kind of like confused about something or a person or what you should do, that sort of thing. So just open up to the guidance coming through, because it is coming through for you, Capricorn. You just have to allow for it and know that you're going to have to lead yourself into a place of unconditional love and for yourself, and balancing more with the spirituality, with your connections, with your meditation, with the divine guidance that comes in. It's like, I feel it's like, oh, it's there and I get what I get. But it's like, are you going and knocking on the door and setting an appointment and sitting down with your guides and making it a thing? Or is it just kind of there? and you know, that sort of thing too. So anyway, there you go, Capricorn. Thank you so much for joining me. I really, really appreciate it. If this if this reading and these messages resonate with you, please give this video a like, leave comments down below. I love to hear from you. Oh, and just to let you know, I'm offering a special on my mediumship services. So I have a video about it and it's on my website. So if you've been feeling a pull to get mediumship services done, now would be the time, because I have an awesome special going on right now. So check that out. Other than that, have a beautiful full moon, Capricorn. Until next time, bye for now.